Health workers fear a coming crisis in aged care services for Indigenous people, warning there isn't enough culturally appropriate care. There are claims Indigenous seniors are facing neglect, racism and financial abuse.
Yeah. 80-year-old Alice Riley's home is a safe place for her large extended family. But local support workers say her generosity often leaves her exposed to overcrowding, drug use and financial abuse.
I think the issue is that people don't see it as financial abuse, do they? Even if it's $20, $50, it varies, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Amounts, but they don't see it as abuse. They see it as Nan helping them out.
Ms Riley needs home support and is waiting to be referred to a suitable carer.
There's services that she needs, but they need to be appropriate. You just can't put a generalist white service in and say, well, we've fixed everything, it's not going to work.
Without culturally appropriate aged care, many families simply don't trust providers.
A lot of families won't consider that because they don't want to put their older family members, who usually have chronic disease, into places where they feel that they're going to be abused.
Concerns over racism are also a factor, with many members of the stolen generation now needing aged care.
Putting them into the system that we have now is like re-institutionalising them. They lose their voice. They don't have a say in anything. The same as what they were brought up in homes and missions.
Some families say they have few options.
If she can see an Aboriginal worker or Indigenous worker, she'd be more relaxed. We cannot find anything suitable as of yet, so we are just leaving her in transitional care at the minute.
This week, the Royal Commission focused on aged care in remote areas, but the barriers for Indigenous Australians extend well into the cities. One woman told SBS that she's worried her husband will become a target of mistreatment because he's Aboriginal. As the inquiry continues, one community is already pushing for an Aboriginal aged care community hub in Perth's southern suburbs.
We're all about family, we're all about community and being together, and having elders maybe in an aged care facility where there's no contact with children and family is not something that we want to promote.
The group successfully lobbied for $250,000 in federal funds to plan the centre, but they say land should be returned to the Noongar people of the state's southwest in order to build it.
We want to be able to have a facility that promotes that connection with our young people. And also that learning as well from one generation to the next.
For elders like Ms Riley, it will be a way to meet other seniors and stay connected to family and culture.
I like someone to talk to, you know, like elderly people like myself, elderly people. I just want friendship, you know. All my life I've had a lot of friends, but they all gone too, so.
The Royal Commission into Aged Care resumes in Perth on Monday. Aaron Fernandez, SBS World News.